Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes about ADHD and Autism. Today I will share with you how it was for me as a mother to have a son with special needs and special reactions. I put so much energy in blaming myself because I felt the world was blaming me as a mother and my husband as a dad for not doing it all right. If we were in a shopping center and somebody touches our basket or us or say, hey, please, will you give me... Our son, from he could walk, he would hit them or pull milk at them or do something because it was frightening him. People were frightening him. Touch, all kind of touch was frightening him. And again, I only saw people's reaction. I didn't see my son's, son. It took me years to find out that I had to stand up for my son. And all those years, I felt the world were blaming me for being a bad mother. It was our grandparents, when they came to visit us, he wouldn't shake hands, he wouldn't hug. He maybe wouldn't reply if he was asked about something. If we had visitors, he had so much movement in his body, and often he broke a dish or dropped his milk on the floor, or not on purpose, but because of stress. And again, I blamed him because I felt the world blamed me. I felt that grandma was looking at me with eyes who said, what, can't you even make your son shake my hand? Huh? She didn't say it, but I felt it. And when we walked to church, we stopped for a long time because of this, and the organ started playing. He would maybe be yelling, maybe laying on the floor, screaming or something like that. And people looked at me with eyes who said, why don't you control your kid? So we hid it a little bit up at home. We only went out in shifts, so one of us stayed home and the boy could stay home too. It was actually, he was about 5 or 6 years old before the first time a person looked me in my eyes and said, wow, you have done so well as a mother. I was actually in shock. I couldn't believe what I was hearing because I've always heard that I was a bad mother. I couldn't raise my son on a proper way. I couldn't make him a good citizen in my country and all that. Some of the people said to me and some of it my head told myself. But this person was, she was supposed to help my son because he react very aggressive to all kind of touch. And that was a tough thing when you were 5 years old in a kindergarten and you hit everybody down if they touch you a little bit. So she was helping him. Again and again she told me that we have done such a great job. That was what I needed. Put my focus on, instead of on the world was blaming me, to me relaxing in being a mother the way I could be a mother. And that I found out that my son's need was not like everybody else's needs was. My son has special needs and I had to meet him in those needs, if I want him to meet my needs. Not that I need that he was always polite, shaking hands, but then I could say to the visitors, my son don't want to shake hands. And I could say to him, please sit at the table while you can, and then leave before you can feel the hyperactivity explode in you. So we met each other from that day off. And it was only because there was a person who saw me and told me that I was doing good. Because as long as we tell our friends or family or the teachers or whatever it is, our kids, you are not good enough to this, then they cannot be better. But if you tell them what they are good at, then they can be better. It's the same for your kids, for your neighbor, for your grandma, for yourself. So I just want all you who knows a family who struggles with ADHD and autism, tell them what they are good at, because they so much need to hear it. So I hope you do, and I hope you who's struggling out there, I hope you will shake your own hand and say, hey, I'm actually good at this. It's okay that my son or my daughter does something. Other people will shake their head because of that. But it's okay. It's not because I'm a bad mother or a bad daddy or bad anything else. I've done my best. And I'll keep doing my best.